All right, children, last time I have given you the flow chart of this. Now, here's an explanation of the flow chart if you haven't understood. So, when I have given you, we are dealing with the topic verbs, right? So, verbs are what? They are actually that part of speech which shows action, state or being or possession. When I talk about action, this action can be a concrete action, a mental action, or a feeling. Like sometimes I say, I think. So think is something which you cannot show. It is going something inside the, I think you are right. So that kind of actions are, you know, the mental action. Fine. Now when I talk about state or being, like the verbs denote, like is the action is in present, past, what is the state there? Then possession, like some verb shows the possession. I have a pen. So here, what is the verb? Have. So whose pen is this? I have. Who has a pen? I have. So when I use have here, it shows the possession. So in this case, the verb is not dealing with action. It's not but instead of action, it shows that it has some possession. Fine. Now further, when I talk about verbs, they can be auxiliary verbs or the main verbs. Now here we need to understand that auxiliary verbs are also called helping verb. Why? Think we have done it earlier. But okay. So auxiliary verbs are the helping verbs. Why? Because they help the main verb to form voices and tenses. So you know that voices and tenses are important part of our grammar. So if we have to form tenses, we have to use auxiliary verb along with the main verb in most of the cases. If we have to form the voices, we definitely need the auxiliary verbs with the main verb. So that is why auxiliary verbs are the verbs which help the main verb to form voices and tenses. So what exactly is the main verb? Main verbs are the verbs that can stand alone as they can be used with auxiliary verbs. As they can be used with auxiliary verbs or helping verbs. Then, fine. Now, in this video particularly, I would like to discuss with you the auxiliary verbs. Fine. And they are further primary auxiliary verbs or modal auxiliary verbs. Now, what are primary auxiliary verbs? These verbs can function both as main verbs and auxiliary verbs. I mean, in absence of another verb, they act as the main verb. Okay? So, it's not essential for the primary auxiliary verbs to always be used with the main verb. But if I talk about modal auxiliary verbs, they always need another verb, or I say main verb, to express a mood or tense. Fine. Now we'll discuss about primary auxiliary verb. We can divide this into three families, which are further be, have, and do. When I talk about be family, if you consider be is the head of the family, we have the members of be, and they are is, am, are, was, were, been, being. Have family, head of the family is who? Yes, have. And who all are the member of have's family? They are has, have, had. Now we have do. Who are the members? Do, does, did. Though I'm not going to discuss modal auxiliary here, but yes, we are going to discuss it as a different chapter. But here I'll tell you, like it is the members of the modal auxiliary verbs are the modal auxiliary verbs are can, could, shall, should, may, might, will, would, ought to, used to, need. Here I want to clear, need can be used as main verb too. So I'm coming to the topic, and today I'm going to discuss the usage of be only. So what is the usage of be? Please listen carefully, try to understand as you people are away, and we have to focus again. Just come on the usage. Progressive tenses, to form progressive tense. The progressive tense is basically continuous tense. When I talk about continuous tense, like I would like to give the example here. I am making, I am making chocolate cake. Chocolate cake. So here I'm talking about the progressive tense or the continuous tense in the present. Like this ing form shows that it's a progressive tense. And how I got to know that this is present? Because I use am here. Instead of am, I could have used was. Again, was is a member of which family? Be family, right? So we can use be family as to form progressive tenses. What is the other use? The other use is to form passive form. So let's discuss to form the passive form here. If I say Rome was not built in a day. So here, was not built in a day. So it's the passive form here. Now I'll come again to frame questions. When I talk about two frame questions, like see if I say here, I have this, I am making chocolate cake. How can you make the here question? I can just bring this in the beginning, auxiliary in the beginning, and my question can be, am I making chocolate? Am I making chocolate cake? So here, this be form is used to frame questions. Similarly, we have the other members which can be used to frame questions. Now, to give short answers to questions. Like, if somebody asks you like a question, just listen, are you going to the movie? So this is a question formed by using the be family member. And if I have to answer, like I can give the short answer. What was the question? Question was, are you going to the movie? So we can say, if many members are going, we can say, yes, we are. Or, yes, I am. So this is a short answer to the question using the member of the be family. Now, I'll discuss here to make question tags. When I talk about to make question tags, if I say, you are telling a lie, and I can say, aren't you? So just please focus here. If I say, you are telling a lie. You are telling a lie. So this is somewhere a question. And if I have to add a question tag, I can say, aren't you? So from where this question tag has come? This has come from the be family. So please go through the notes which I have provided along with this video or in the worksheet and try to do the questions which are given there. Bye.